He has said he will not use the police to do his politics. Every single thing the president has promised, he has done the opposite. He has said he wants to deny the people, but he's getting Kenyans more disgruntled and less united day by day. He said he wants to bring more communities together. He's actually segregating communities and making sure that some communities don't get benefits at all. What is this? So we want this right to be. It stands for the rule of law and it stands for the benefits of the law of every single person in this country. Then we should not be having the same number of cameras and be summoned by the same police. And by the way, he says he doesn't know the kidnappers. We want to tell him we know the kidnappers. And from the story of Mwadi, if he wants to know, let him talk to Mwadi, let him talk to Bob Jaggi, and he will tell you who the kidnappers are.
Ningetaka kuongea kuhusu because he's been threatened and we are very very concerned that Karungo Adhangwa, who is a member of parliament representing, sorry, a senator representing Kiambu, and having attended a funeral peacefully, and he did not even speak, he was not even given the microphone to speak during the funeral, has been summoned to come to me. He represents Kiambu people, not me. We want to know why there is this discriminatory summons. Why everybody else who was in that funeral has not been somebody really, only Karungo Adhango. Could it be just because he's a young person? Or could it be just because he seems not to have people backing him politically like others? Or what is the problem? Why should Karungo be somebody really and that is why we are here? And I'm very happy because Karungo has been brought by leaders from Kiambu, from Machakos, from Makwiny, from Muranga, from Nyandarua. Tumekuja hapa kwa sababu we are getting worried. The trends at which the police is interfering in the political process and even religious processes of this country is very worried in Mount Kenya. We are sleeping in fear. We are driving in fear. We are not even going to churches anymore because we are fearing we might be abducted along the way. It is time for us to speak because siko ongea maneno yake vizuri. We would want to understand what's going on. To be dumped somewhere in Gong Road, saa kumi ya asubuhi. Only after that, Mwadi's friends and their associates, wenye wanafanya kazi na wao, wakashikwa. Vijana wadogo wadogo wa kuuza mandazi, vijana wadogo wadogo wa kuuza kahawa, wanashikwa wanapelekwa kwa DCI, wanaambiwa andike statement kwa nini walikuwa naenda mazishi. Kwani siku hizi tunakuwa tunaomba ruhusa kwenda mazishi? Tunakuwa tunaomba ruhusa kwenda kanisa? No, it's getting out of hand. And that is why we are here. And we need the world to know what is going on. People are getting intimidated every day, abducted every day. Jana nilipigwa simu na mama akorwai akaniambia mtoto wake alipotea. Hivo tu mtoto anaitwa Shege. Alipotea tu hivo. Hajapatikana for about 6 months now. And nobody speaks. Nobody is bothered. Mama Shege hana nguvu ya kuongea. Sisi ambao tuko na nguvu ya kuongea lazima tunaongea. Kwa hivyo tunasema si lazima tuende kotini ndio tuwe uhuru, sababu katiba yetu ya Kenya imetupatia nafasi ya kuwa huru katika Kenya yetu. We are not going to be running to court every day to get orders to allow us to go to church, to get orders to go to funerals, to get orders to go to weddings. No, the Kenyan constitution has given us our rights and our rights must be protected. And therefore I want to address the police of this country. I want to remind them that the Constitution of Kenya has given them the mandate to do their work. But they are not mandated to interfere with religious and cultural and social activities of Kenyans. Hatutaacha kwenda mazishi kwa sababu polisi wanakuchika. Hatutaacha kwenda kanisa kwa sababu wahubiri wanapatwa ama sisi tunapatwa. That must stop. Number two, Kenya is now becoming a police state. where everything has to be sanctioned by the police. Niliambiwa na rafiki yangu mwingine hapa amefanya pre-wedding pale Kiambu. Ati akaletewa barua na DC kuambiwa ati usifanye pre-wedding party. Hatutakuwa tunafanya pre-weddings kwa sababu this is a police issue now. No.